So good morning, children. Today I continue the explanation of voice, part 4. In today's class, I explain about changing of questions from active to passive. First of all, what is the difference between a question and a statement? You have to know. In a question, verb comes first, subject comes later, and at the end there is question mark. But in a statement, subject comes first, verb comes later. Simply, you have to reverse. For example, I am going to school. Am I going to school? If there is helping verb, simply you have to reverse that helping verb and subject. Automatically it becomes a question. I am going to school. Change it into your positive yes no question. Am I going to school? What did you do in that sentence? Simply you reversed am helping verb and I subject. Automatically it became a question. They were working in the field. What is the verb? Helping verb? Work. Were they? Simply reverse verb, then helping verb and subject, they. Automatically it becomes positive yes no question. If you add suitable WH question word before a positive yes no question, automatically it becomes a positive WH question. If you keep any WH question word before positive yes no question, automatically it becomes positive yes no question. They were working in the field. Were they working in the field? Positive yes no question. Simply you have to reverse helping verb and object. Were they working in the field? If you keep suitable WH question word, how were they working in the field? How were they working in the field? Automatically it becomes a positive WH question. So if a statement is given, you have to change it into different sentences. Positive statement should be changed into negative statement. Again, positive statement should be changed into positive yes no question. Next, positive yes no question should be changed into positive WH question. Next, negative statement should be changed into negative yes no question. Same negative yes no question should be changed into negative WH question. So, six structures. Positive statement, positive yes no question, positive WH question, negative statement, negative yes no question, negative WH question. So this is the process. So here, when there is main verb in a sentence, he went to Guntur yesterday. You cannot reverse here went to he. Went main verb. When there is only helping verb, you can reverse that helping verb and subject. Automatically becomes a question. But when there is main verb, that method is not possible. You cannot change that main verb plus subject to reverse. He went to Guntur. He is subject to went to main verb. It is not helping verb. So you have to follow other method to change such kind of sentences into questions. If there is main verb in a sentence, you have to take the help of do, does or did helping verbs. Do, does or did. For example, he went to Guntur. You have to change it into question. Went past tense, so you have to start the question with did. Did he go? Did plus go becomes went. Did he went wrong? If you write did he went to Guntur wrong? Because one more grammar rule is there. After do, does, did, there must be only V1 form. Verb form 1, that means present tense. You cannot write past tense under any circumstances. So, did he go to Guntur yesterday? That is question. Why did you take did here? Because went main verb is in past tense. That's why question should begin with did plus V1 form. Did plus subject plus V1 form. That is the structure of the question. For example, he loves melodious music. loves also presented with yes. You cannot reverse that loves or likes and subject. You cannot reverse. So present tense with yes. So you have to take it. Does. Does he love melodious music? Or does he like melodious music? Because does is there. So present tense yes with yes is there. So when the verb is in present tense with yes or yes also, you can take does to start a question. Plus V1 form. Does he love? Does he like melodious music? Next, I like sweets. Here main verb present tense without s or es is given. Main verb present tense without s or es. Then you have to take the help of do. Do I like sweets? Do I like sweets? Simple present tense. After do, does, did, we have take only simple present tense. That's why this is the way to change a statement into questions. When there is helping verb in a sentence, simply you have to reverse that helping verb and subject. Automatically it becomes positive yes no question. Again, what is yes no question? That is a doubt for many people, students. A sentence, a question which has the answer yes or no. A sentence, a question which has the answer yes or no is called yes no question. Because for such questions you need not say full answer. Are you going to school? Yes or no question. You can simply say yes or no. No need of telling I am going to school. Yes represents the entire answer, I am going to school. If you want to say no, simply say no. Are you going to school? No. No represents the entire sentence, I am not going to school. That's why such questions are called yes or no questions. These are also called verbal questions. These questions are also called verbal questions. Verbal question means those questions begin with the verb. Did he went to go to? Do you like music? Does he love music? Helping verbs. These questions begin with the verbs. That's why these questions are also called verbal questions. So here, in a question, subject comes first, verb comes first, subject comes later. But in a statement, subject comes first, verb comes later. That is the main thing you have to remember. In voice, questions also can be changed into active to passive. So, in every sentence, whether it is question or imperative or statement, in voice, first you have to try to find out what is the term, what is subject, what is verb and its tense, what is object, whether it is singular or plural. These are the three things we need to change a sentence from the active into passive. First, after reading sentence, try to find out these three. What is subject, what is verb and its tense, what is the object. Here, in questions, active voice also is given in the question form. Passive voice also should be changed into question form. You cannot change a question into statement. That also you have to remember. For example, when did you finish your homework? This is the question. After reading it, what shall you do first? First you have to find out what is subject. What is subject here? You. When did you? You are doing that thing. Next, what is the verb and its tense? Verb plus is equal to did plus finished. Did plus finished is equal to finished. In the question, verb plus is given like that. Do plus V1, did plus V1, or does plus V1. Compulsory. That's why, if you want to find out the tense of the verb, you should not take not only the main verb, you should not take not only helping verb, did. But after watching did, you can come to conclusion that the verb of is in past tense. That the verb is in past tense. Because did plus V1 is there. This is the real verb. Did plus finish is equal to finished. So, what is the tense of the verb? V2 form. For example, verb is a neuter form. We got subject you. What the object? Your homework. How do you find out an object? If you possess the verb with what or whom, you can find out object. So what did you finish? What did you finish? Your homework. What the object? In the sentence, object is your homework. Is it singular or plural? It is singular. So this part is object. Singular object. Just like in past tense, we have to use two be forms. Already I explained. When the object is singular, you have to use was be form. When the verb is in past tense. When the object is plural and the verb is in past tense, you have to take the be form were. So according to that formula, we took a singular object. What the suitable be form? Was. Same formula. We took a plural object. What the suitable be form? Were. These are the two things you have to remember. But structure of the sentence is important. You have to remember, you have to follow. How to write thus was in the question form itself. You have to remember one important thing. In a question, verb comes first, to subject comes later. That is most important. But if you write by mistake, subject first, to verb next, to, it will be wrong. That should be remembered. Here what you can see. Passive voice also should be in the question form. So, same WH with this WH question word, passive voice should be started. Okay, then this is okay. Next step, you have to write the suitable be form. What is suitable be form? Regarding the structure, did plus finish past tense verb, your homework, singular object. So, when the verb is in past tense and the object is singular, suitable be form is was. So, you have to write when was. When was? Was helping verb. It came first. Next you have to write subject. What is the subject here? Your homework. Object is the object. Object becomes a new subject in passive voice. So when was your homework? Stop there. Afterwards, be form, be three form you have to write. What is the verb here? Main verb? Finish. For finish, you have to write be three form. Finish, finish, finish. So, when was your homework finished? After V3 form, as usual, we are trying to by preposition. Next, new subject becomes a new object. What is the subject here? You. So, it becomes automatically new object. Afterwards, question mark compulsory. If you don't keep question mark, if you forget question mark, your answer will be wrong. But if you write, when your homework was finished, it will be wrong. When your homework was finished by you is wrong. Why? You are writing, you are framing a question. In a question, after WH question word, there must be verb, that means helping verb. But you wrote when your homework subject, object. Object becomes subject, this is a noun. It is subject. So, first you wrote subject, afterwards you wrote was verb. Automatically, your answer will be wrong. So, you must take care of that structure. After WH question mark, there must be helping verb. That means be form. When was. Next, object becomes new subject. Your homework. Next, V3 form. Finish, finish, finish. After V3, by preposition. Next, subject becomes new object. Compulsory, there must be question mark. This is the way to change your active voice into passive voice, especially questions. Next question. How did you solve this problem? Read the sentence, find out those three things. How is WH question word? Passive voice also should be with the same WH question word. Next, what the verb? Did plus solve. Past tense, solve. V2. What is the object to this problem? Is it singular or plural? Singular. So, V2 plus a singular object. What is the B form? Was. Was. Oh, next. How was this problem solve by WH question word how. Was is the suitable B form, V2 plus singular object. Next, object is this problem, this becomes new subject. How was this problem? V3 form, solved by you. Next, what did you do yesterday? Here, what is the subject? Subject is included in what? What the verb did plus do? Past tense. You subject. You subject. Object is included in what? So, question should begin with, passive should begin with what? What is the suitable be form? V2 plus singular object. Imagine object here. So, was be form. So, what was done? Do did it done with the form by you yesterday? Question mark. Who killed Ravana? Here you have to simply think about the WH question word. In the above questions, what, when, how. But here, who is given? When, who is given an active voice? Passive voice should begin with the who, by who, by whom. Afterwards, B form, same process. By whom? V2 plus the singular object. What is the suitable B form? Was. By whom was Ravana killed? Question mark. But if you write by whom Ravana was killed, it will be wrong. Because Ravana subject was verb. In a question, verb must come first, subject comes later. That's why you are right. By whom was Ravana killed? That is the right answer. But if you write by whom Ravana was killed, that is wrong. Because we are writing the question form. In a question form, verb comes first, subject comes later. That is about those questions. One more example. When the object is plural, when did you write these articles? Read the question. When did you write? Did plus write. Past tense. You subject. Object is these articles. Is it singular or plural? Plural object. So, in plural, V2 plus plural object, what the B form? What? This is the formula. So, these articles, plural object. So, question should, passive voice should begin with when. Next, plural object. What is suitable be form? Were. When were, object becomes new subject. These articles, articles, write, wrote, written with the form. Written plus by preposition. You, subject becomes new object. When the object is plural. This is about singular and plural objects. And I explain some different questions. Thank you. did Ghatasala sing Hindi songs? So observe this question. Did Ghatasala sing Hindi songs? Did plus sing, we to form Ghatasala subject, Hindi songs plural object. So we got subject, verb one is tense, object. Easily we can change it into passive voice. So here passive voice should be with be form. This is also called helping verb. Helping verb also. So what is suitable be form? V2 plus the plural object. In this sense, plural object. So according to our formula, V2 plus plural object to one is before. V2 plus singular object was before. So here passive voice should be with while. Where is suitable be form? Moreover, it will be taken as helping verb also. Question form. Verb plus object becomes his subject. Object is Hindi songs. So verb Hindi songs sing sang sun with reform. But Hindi songs sung after with by preposition. Sung by Ghatasala. Question or compulsory. So this is also helping verb, this is also helping verb, but verb is treated as be form. So this question should be changed like this. Next question. Do you like music? Read the sentence. Do you like music? Do like present tense. You subject, music object, singular object. So what is suitable be form? V1 plus a singular object is be form. So passive voice should begin with is. Is. Next, what the object? Music. Music becomes a you subject. Is music. Next, with the form of like. Like. Is music like after repeating by preposition. After by preposition, you. Is music like by you? Passive voice. Next. She prepares food deliciously. Question. Does she prepare food? Does she prepare food deliciously? Question mark. Does prepare is equal to prepares. V1. She subject. Object, singular object, food. So V1 plus a singular object, again, suitable be form is. Is, next object becomes new subject. Is food, food, prepare verb, prepared. Is food prepared by her, she becomes her, by her, deliciously. Deliciously, question mark. Here we started passive voice with is because is a suitable be form. When the verb is in present tense, object is singular. What is a suitable be form? Is. That's why passive voice should be with is. Is food prepared by her deliciously? These are some questions. Next, continuous tense. In continuous tense also questions are given. Such kind of questions also we must be able to change into passive voice.
Telugu songs sung by or Telugu songs sung by Anuradha.
Our Telugu song sung by Anuradha. What kind of sentence is this? Is it a passive voice or active voice? How do you find out an active voice or passive voice? What are the main difference between active voice and passive voice? These are the things you have to learn. In passive voice, compulsory there must be by preposition. After by, there must be V3 form. Compulsory. Here, sung V3 form by preposition. Afterwards, some new object is there. Automatically, it is in passive voice. Passive voice should be changed into active voice. How? For example, our Telugu songs sung by Anuradha. Object to Anuradha is singular. Here, verb. Our Telugu songs, present tense. V2 plus singular object. V form. Question should begin with does. Does Anuradha, another third person, does Anuradha sing? Does Anuradha sing Telugu songs? Question. Yes, some students may get doubt. Why should we take does? See, the sentence is in simple present tense. Or is there present tense? Anuradha, singular object. So, question with third person singulars, we have to start the question with the does. That is the rule. With the third person singular, if you have to frame your question in present tense, you have to take does. If it is first person or second person, if you have to write it in simple present tense, you can take do, do I, do we, do you, present tense. If it is third person singular, you have to start the question with the does. Because of that reason, active voice should begin with the does. Plus third person singular object Anuradha, does Anuradha. Present tense, after does, we have to write only V1 without case, sing. Sung V3 is given, for that what is present tense, sing. Does Anuradha sing? What the subject here? Telugu songs. It becomes object, Telugu songs. So, this is passive voice. This is active voice. One more question, continuous tense. Are you preparing English for the exam? Question. Are you preparing? It is present continuous tense. You subject. English is a singular object. So we got subjective, verb, and it's a tense plus object, singular. So we have to change it into passive voice in the question form itself. So what is the suitable B form here? Are you preparing English? Subject is singular. So you have to take the structure of is plus being plus V3. is plus b plus v3. If this plural object r plus b plus v3, if the object is v, it becomes I. So with I we have to use m plus b plus v3. So in present tense three b forms are there. Yam is R. Yam is used only with I. Is used with only other singular subjects rather than me. R is used with all plural objects. Is other singular objects. Yam with only me object. In the same way, in continuous tense also present continuous, three structures will be there. Three structures are there. Yam plus B plus V3. Is plus B plus V3. R plus B plus V3. Yam plus B plus 3 is taken when the object is me. Is plus B plus V3 is taken when the object is other singular subject rather than me. R plus B plus V3 is taken when the object is plural. So here what the object in English? Singular. So we have to take the structure of is plus B plus V3. So passive voice also should begin with the helping verb is. It is taken as B form here. Start. Is. Next, object becomes new subject. Is English. Continuous tense. We have to use being. Is English. B-E-I-N-G. Being. After being, V3. V3 for prepared. Prepare, prepared, prepared. Is English being prepared after V3 by preposition. After by, you are correct, new object. U is subject here, it becomes new object. This is a passive voice. Is English being prepared by you? That is passive voice. So you must be very careful while changing questions from active into passive. You may, first after reading sentence, three things you have to find out. What is the subject? What is the object? What the tense of the verb? If you find these three, automatically change. Next one, plural object. When the object is plural, is he selling baskets? Baskets in the market. Market. Read the sentence. Is he selling baskets in the market? What the tense? This is the end of the sentence. Is plus sell plus ing form. Present continuous tense. Okay, we got the tense of the verb. Next, what is subject? He. What is object? Object to baskets. Baskets to plural. Plural object is there. Tense is present continuous. So, what is the suitable structure? R plus, B plus, V3 plus, Y. So, passive should begin with R. Baskets plural. So R object becomes a new subject. R baskets continuous tense. Being sell sold. R baskets being sold. Next subject becomes object. He becomes him. By him. Next other word. In the market? Question mark. Are baskets being sold by him? By is missing. By him. By him in the market. This is the answer. Next one. Can you read the sentence? Can you solve this problem? Already I explained, with all modal verbs we can use be form, BEV. Here can is there. Can, could, shall, should, may, might, will, would, must, have modal verbs. So can you solve this problem? Can solve verb, new subject, this problem object. So object becomes new subject. Question should begin with can. Can plus object becomes new subject. Can this problem? Stop there. Next, suitable be formed. With can, will, shall, should, may, might, must, you have to take the B form. B, B. Can this problem be, after B form, with B form, for solve. Can this problem be solved? After with B form, by preposition, by you, subject. You, subject form, object form, same. That's why. Can this problem be solved by you? That's the question. Come here.